Sup everyone and welcome to an unboxing video of the MSI B450M Bazooka Plus AM4 motherboard, where we'll also be answering a very important question. Will this board handle the latest AMD Ryzen 3000 series processors? Let's find out. Okay, let's start with a bit of background on this board. As its name implies, the board is powered by the AMD B450 chipset, and it comes in the micro ATX form factor. Now, the B450 was originally released around July to August 2018, and B450 boards were really meant to accompany the Ryzen 2000 series processors that were released a couple of months earlier than the B450 chipset. Fast forward till today, we see that AMD has kept its word in terms of ensuring that the latest Ryzen 3000 series of processors would be backwards compatible with the 400 series chipsets and even the 300 series chipsets. And we'll see today if the MSI B450M Bazooka Plus will have any issues if we were to install a Ryzen 3000 series processor on it. Okay, onto the packaging. Already I'm liking the whole grey and bazooka-like thingy that's going on with the box. It's so much better looking than the ASRock X570M Pro 4 that I reviewed in an earlier video. Well, it's probably because this board is targeted at gamers, which explains this whole Arsenal gaming thing at the top of the box, which also explains the name B450M Bazooka Plus, which is totally dripping manliness and testosterone. Anyway, it is a good first impression. I really like the design of the box. Let's have a look inside. Let's dig right in. Let's get the motherboard out of the way first. We'll take a closer look at it after we're done with the contents of the box and the cardboard divider. Here we go. So we get your usual DVD disc with drivers, a leaflet of sorts, and wow, the MSI Arsenal Gaming case badge, I suppose. It's a very nice touch. I think it's made of metal, but it's really cool. So anyway, you do get a leaflet on the true gaming lineup. Some are PC, we are gaming. That's some nice English there. Glossing over that, you get a nice, a thank you note from MSI as well. Does it do anything? It reminds you to register your product on MSI's website. Okay. Quick installation guide for you folks who might, you know, for some odd reason, forget how to install a processor or a heatsink fan. Nice touch again. There you go. Manual, user manual for the board, as expected. This is your M2 drive screw, just one. And SATA cables, two of them, and a I/O shield. Now this is a good looking I/O shield, I must say. I really dig the whole black on silver appearance, and it also has this MSI, is it Arsenal Gaming emblem? I don't know what emblem it stands for, but it looks really cool. And I mean, come on guys, look at the packaging and the contents of the MSI B450M Bazooka Plus and tell me, isn't this so much better than the ASRock X570M Pro 4, which I must remind you is a premium board and uses a premium chipset. This on the other hand is a board that is so much cheaper than the ASRock X570M Pro 4. Again, I really wish ASRock had done a little bit more in terms of the contents of the box, in terms of the appearance, but there you have it. I'm really impressed with what MSI has provided for the B450M Bazooka Plus board. So let's move on and take a closer look at the board itself. Here we go, the MSI B450M Bazooka Plus board in the flesh. First impressions, I really like how it looks, especially given, you know, the design of the VRM heatsink, which is pretty chunky, the design of the chipset heatsink right here, as well as the accents and the patterns that you get on the PCB. It lends a very nice military-like kind of feel, which I guess that is what MSI is trying to gun for, especially with its range of Arsenal gaming boards and the B450M Bazooka Plus here in particular. So it's pretty nice. That said, it does come with four DDR4 slots here with support for up to 64GB of RAM and DDR4 speeds of up to 3333MHz. It does come with a single PCIe 3.0 x16 slot right here for your graphics card. And it also has this MSI steel armor thing where supposedly the PCIe x16 slot is stronger. I'm not sure if this is just a marketing gimmick. I mean, a lot of motherboard manufacturers nowadays also have very similar slot designs with so-called metal reinforcement. But it's still a nice touch. It does make the slot look pretty nice. In terms of storage capabilities, the board comes with a single M.2 connector right here and four SATA 3 connectors down by the side. In terms of front panel connectivity, you get your usual front audio connector here, front panel connector here, USB 3 connectors and so on. Pretty run of the mill. In terms of RGB connectivity, you do get two 12-volt RGB headers, one's right here and the other one at the top over here. It does not come with an onboard addressable RGB header, so do take note of that, especially for you folks out there who have addressable RGB devices. In terms of audio, this board's audio is powered by a Realtek ALC892 chip, which is right here, and LAN connectivity is powered by the Realtek 8111H chip, which is right here. So yes, there you have it. This is a quick look at the board itself. Moving over to the rear I/O ports for this board, we see that it comes with DVI, HDMI, two USB 2.0 Type-A ports, four USB 3.1 Type-A Gen 1 ports, your LAN port, your audio ports, and a PS2 port for those of you folks out there who are still living in PS2 LAN with a old PS2 mouse and or a keyboard. That said, I do like how MSI has included these red plastic bits for the USB 3.1 ports, the LAN port, and the PS2 port. It adds a certain pizzazz to the overall appearance of the board, which is very much in line with the whole gaming theme that MSI has got going on for the B450M Bazooka Plus. So it's really nice. That said, you'll notice that there's this little button right between the HDMI ports and the USB 2.0 ports. Now this is what MSI calls a BIOS Flashback button. It's actually a really nifty feature to have. What it does is that it allows users to update the BIOS for their motherboard without needing to install a processor or RAM. So in other words, this is a very, very useful feature to have in today's context, especially now that the Ryzen 3000 series of processors have been released. Why? This is because a lot of these B450 boards, X470, X370 boards, they don't have support for the Ryzen 3000 series processors out of the box with older versions of BIOS. Users would have to update to a Ryzen 3000 series compatible BIOS before they can start using their older boards with these new processors. Now in our context today, obviously I've got a Ryzen 3000 series processor ready to go together with this board, but seeing as this board was very likely manufactured before the Ryzen 3000 series processors were released, I will very likely have to do this BIOS flashback thing. Get the latest version of the BIOS onto the board, and then we'll see if this board will work with a Ryzen 3000 series processor. Specifically for this board, I've got a Ryzen 3 3200G that will be installed together with this board for a new build that I'm putting together. So without further ado, let's take a look at the entire BIOS flashback process and see if it actually works. Okay, as you can see, I've got the motherboard all set up, it's hooked up to the power supply, and we're now ready to use the MSI BIOS flashback feature. Now, according to MSI, what you've got to do is make sure that your power supply's 24-pin connector is connected to the board, as well as the 8-pin CPU power connector as well, and that's it, that's all you need. As you can see, I don't have a processor installed, neither do I have any RAM installed. Now the next thing to do is to make sure that you have on hand a FAT32 formatted thumb drive. You've got to download the BIOS ROM file into the said thumb drive. Thereafter, you have to rename the BIOS file name to msi.rom. And once that's done, you're pretty much good to go. All you need to do is simply attach, connect it to the designated BIOS Flashback USB port, like so, which is just here next to the button, and press the button and you're good to go. Now, after pressing the button, I'm supposed to see some red LED come to life and start blinking. How MSI indicates that the BIOS Flashback feature has completed its thing is that the red LED will stop flashing, so here goes nothing. Just gonna double check that the power supply is on. Yep, it's on. Let's go. And here we go. Well, that scared me for a moment. I thought that the board was dead on arrival, but there you have it. The red LED is flashing. There's a white LED in the background as well. Let's see how long this takes. Now, according to MSI's video, it recommended that the entire process should take no longer than 5 minutes. Well, let's have a look at how long this entire process takes. And it looks like we're done. So both the red LED and the white LED have gone off and now it's come back on again. Oh no, is that a good sign? Am I supposed to power it off? But yeah, in any case, it looks like once the entire process is done, the red LED should stop. So I guess that's a sign for me to unplug the thumb drive. Okay, so sit rep, the red LED has gone off, but the white LED over there is still on and I can see the power supply fan still spinning. Now this is something unexpected because according to MSI's video, there shouldn't be any LEDs lit, and for the board that they used to demonstrate the entire BIOS Flashback process, they were using the Bazooka Plus as well, and that didn't have the white LED flat switched on in the background. So I'm not sure if I've bricked the board, but in any case, I think the next step that I'll be taking is to switch off the mains to the power supply and pray hope that I haven't corrupted the BIOS. I guess the only way to find out really is to install the processor and pray hope that it posts. Okay, so as you can see, I've got the processor installed alongside two sticks of RAM. It's hooked up to the power supply. I think the only thing that's left to do really is to make sure that this board will post, especially now that we've applied the BIOS update through the Flashback button feature. And, well, we've also got to see whether or not it'll post with a Ryzen 3000 series processor installed. Speaking of the installed processor, I have here the AMD Ryzen 3 3200G installed on the board. This processor comes with the integrated Radeon Vega 8 graphics. The use case for this board and processor, I'll be putting it together for a build that I'm doing for a friend. Now this friend of mine will be using it for your usual office productivity suite. So you're talking about the likes of Microsoft Word, Excel and PowerPoint. It'll probably be used for YouTube streaming, Netflix streaming and the like, but no gaming is likely to be done with this board, which is the reason why I've decided to go with the Ryzen 3 series of processors with integrated graphics. So yes, let's talk about the RAM that I've installed as well. I've got Crucial DDR4 2666 RAMs installed on this board, so that's two sticks of 8 gigs to give you a total of 16 GB. Okay, enough of me talking. The only thing left really is to make sure that this board will post, and here goes. Oh wait, before that, I've forgotten to switch on the power supply. It's on now, and let's see if this board will post. Okay, the motherboard LEDs have come on, so that's a good sign. Let's take a look at the screen and see if it shows anything. Aha, Arsenal Gaming. And it's gone into the BIOS, which is a good sign. So, let's see. System information. Well, it doesn't really say much about what processor is installed, but it's detected the cache size and L3 cache size. Now, I can't quite remember what's in this processor in terms of the cache size, but well, it's detected, and it's also successfully detected the 16 gigs of RAM that I've installed. So yeah, it looks like it's a success. It looks like the BIOS flashback button does indeed work, and I've successfully flashed the BIOS to a version that supports the Ryzen 3000 series processors. Now I'm going to take the next couple of minutes to take a closer look at the BIOS, but overall, I think we can term this a great success. Okay, so I've had some time to look into the BIOS and all, and everything checks out fine. So let's round up this video with a couple of observations. For seasoned MSI users, you'll notice that the BIOS here looks rather stripped down, without the usual fancy graphics that you've probably become accustomed to. This is because MSI has had to shrink the BIOS as much as possible so as to accommodate the lines of codes to enable Ryzen 3000 support, where in the process of doing so, they have had to ditch the Click BIOS interface and drop some support for older AM4 chips from the Bristol Ridge era. Apparently, they have had to do so due to BIOS ROM size limitations, where the 16MB ROM chips that MSI has on its older boards were simply not large enough. Anyway, in all honesty, I would say that these are not going to be issues at all for many users out there. And on the whole, I would say that the MSI B450M Bazooka Plus is definitely a worthy contender for a new Ryzen 3000 series build. Granted, I haven't had the chance to install a high-end Ryzen 3000 series chip in this board, such as the 3950X for instance, but I've had a look around the internet and it looks like the B450M Bazooka Plus is not going to have a problem with even the Ryzen 3950X. I found an interesting Google Docs spreadsheet put up by CR1318 over at the Reddit forums, and it looks like this board's VRMs are pretty beefy and surprisingly able to handle even an overclocked 3950X, though I must say your mileage may vary depending on the setup that you have. In any case, I've provided the link to the said Google Docs in the video description down below. And for your information, I've paid $138 for this board, which translates into an approximate $100 for you overseas folks, which I must say is great value for money for a mid-range build. Sure, you've only got like one M.2 slot, one 12-volt RGB header, run-of-the-mill audio and LAN, but let's face it, not many folks out there will require any more than the features that are already present on this board. All in all, I think I would strongly recommend the MSI B450M Bazooka Plus should you be in the market for a B450 board for your upcoming Ryzen 3000 series build. With that, thanks for watching this video, and I hope that it's been really useful for you guys. Do like it if you've enjoyed it, and I hope to see you guys the next time round. Cheers!